Yu-Gi-Oh! Is a game with over 100 cards, and 99% of those cards are bad.
However,
these bad cards still make it into players' Edison Format decks every single day. Join me as I dive deep into the abyss of bad card design and put these unloved pieces of cardboard to the ultimate test. Three duels against random strangers on the internet. At the end of each episode, we'll reveal each card's place on the cursed tech tier list, ranking them from almost competitive to downright unplayable trash. Will we stumble upon a broken combo, invent a new deck, or will we just go insane trying to win a duel using Frog the Jam? You will just have to wait and find out. This is Cursed Tech. Hello and welcome to Cursed Tech. Remember two episodes ago when I looked at DNA surgery? Well, today we are looking at DNA surgery's unholy cousin, DNA Transplant. You see, while DNA surgery changes the type of all monsters on the field, DNA Transplant changes the attribute. There's a small community of people trying to break DNA surgery, trying to make it work in Edison format, but nobody would ever try to make DNA Transplant work. Except for me. And you're probably thinking, how are you going to do that? How are you going to accomplish this? Is it maybe changing your monsters to light and then you can use Honest at any time? Is it using Element Absorber to build your own infinite negate attack? No. You see, what I've stumbled upon is something that I think is fire. And yes, I did just make the same joke from last episode. We are playing another burn deck. We are using DNA Transplant to turn all monsters on the field into fire monsters. And then we're playing burn. Step number one, activate DNA Transplant calling fire. Step number two, use some sort of Mark of the Rose, brain control type of card to steal my opponent's monster, which remember is now a fire monster. Step number three, attack with said monster, maybe get in some damage. Step number four, use Spiritual Fire Art Kuranai to tribute my opponent's monster in order to burn my opponent. And hilariously, this combo works also with Soul Exchange. I don't know if everyone knows out there, but Soul Exchange does not have to be used for a tribute summon, only for a tribute. I remember back in my Frog Monarch days, I would use Soul Exchange with Enemy Controller to tribute my opponent's monster to take control of my opponent's other monster. You can use Soul Exchange to tribute your opponent's fire monster to burn your opponent. So it's removal and burn all in one. It's just such a funny interaction, and that's the main focus of today's episode. So here is the deck list I have created to fulfill this dream. And as you can tell, it is Amaryllis Burn. Emphasis on burn. I would say the key card in this deck is probably Lava Call, because what you can do is you can tribute your opponent's two monsters to summon Lava Golem. Then you can use your Mark of the Rose, your Brain Control to steal said Lava Golem, attack your opponent for 3,000 damage, and then you can use Spiritual Fire Art Kuranai to tribute that Lava Golem and inflict 3,000 burn damage. Or you just let Mark of the Rose resolve and give your opponent back the Lava Golem to deal the final 1,000 burn in their standby phase. I also want to mention Quick Draw is especially great in this list because, for some reason, Nitro Warrior is a fire monster. It's just a fire. So you can use Quick Draw and Dandelion to make a Nitro Warrior, attack your opponent for 28, flip Spiritual Fire Art Kuranai and burn your opponent for 28. If you get aggressive in this deck, there's just so many ways to close out the damage with Spiritual Fire Art. It's an insane burn card. I would say the primary flaw in this deck specifically is DNA Transplant only combos with Spiritual Fire Art Kuranai. In every other instance, the card does nothing. But it's cursed tech. We have to play three copies. But for now, let's get into the games. This first game, we are up against Frogs, and thankfully, we are going first. Our opening hand looks, pretty good. We've got a pretty decent normal summon in Cyber Valley, so we're going to just summon that Cyber Valley, set the Spiritual Fire Art Kuranai, and pass the turn. My opponent's just going to
pass the turn right back, and we have no way to do any damage, so we're just going to change Cyber Valley to defense and pass again. Not much going on in this game. My opponent is then going to normal summon Kinkabiyu, activate creature swap, giving us the Kinkabiyu, and because it is a spirit monster, it will go back to my opponent's hand. I love Yu-Gi-Oh! We draw a very good card in Phinuxian Cluster Amaryllis. We're then going to activate Trade-In, discarding that Amaryllis, drawing it two new cards. We're then going to special summon this quick draw from our hand, discarding the Volcanic Counter. We're going to activate Hidden Armory, which happens to mill a plant monster because we are just very good. This will add the DDR from our deck to our hand. And then we can activate Mark of the Rose, banishing the plant monster we just milled, to steal their Cyber Valley, which happens to be a level 1, so we can make a Drill Warrior using our Quick Draw and their level 1, which was our level 1. There's been a lot of flip-flopping monsters this game. We summon the Drill Warrior, we go into the battle phase and attack for 2400 damage, and my opponent has the Trigodia, which is very large. We're then going to go into main phase 2. We are going to activate Drill Warrior, discarding the Cyber Valley, set DNA Transplant, and then pass the turn. They activate Moray of Greed, putting three cards from their hand back into their deck. They don't show me, but you know what? I trust them. I trust they were water monsters. And then they are just going to normal summon a Unifrog, and then they are going to go into the battle phase, and we take the 400 damage, and unfortunately, Volcanic Counter is mandatory, and so it has to banish on this attack. We will both take 400 damage, and then my opponent will attack us for 3,000. My opponent is then just going to pass their turn. We draw a Foolish Burial, which is pretty good. We're going to get that Drill Warrior back in the standby phase. We can use that Drill Warrior's effect to add a Cyber Valley from our graveyard to our hand. And look at this. We have the combo. We have DNA Transplant. We have Spiritual Fire, our Kurenai, and we have Soul Exchange. There is just one major problem. Spiritual Fire Arcur and I has to do original attack. And Trigodia is a question mark monster, so it does not have an original attack. We can change it to a fire monster, activate Soul Exchange to tribute it to deal damage to him, but guess what? It wouldn't do any damage because its original attack counts as zero. Although we could do the combo, we don't need to because it is very bad in this instance. We're going to activate Foolish Burial. This will send a Volcanic Counter from our deck to the graveyard. We're then going to activate DDR, discarding the Soul Exchange to summon our own Volcanic Counter. We then go into the battle phase, and we are going to attack over this Unifrog for 2,000. We're then going to attack into this Trigodia with this Cyber Valley. We both take 3,000 damage because of this Volcanic Counter. You know what we're going to do now? We're just going to activate DNA Transplant, call fire, and although we could tribute either monster, we're going to tribute the Drill Warrior to kill our opponent because Drill Warrior is a fire monster now. It is time for game number 2, and our hand looks pretty interesting. They Moray again without showing us. I love it. I believe them. I have no doubt that I'm not even going to check. I know I could show hands and see if they did, but I believe that Death Machine is an honest player, and he would not cheat me. He draws 3 cards. He's then going to activate 1-for-1, discarding Poison Draw Frog. And as soon as I see Poison Draw Frog, I know I'm playing against an insane deck, because only insane decks play Poison Draw Frog. He's going to summon out the Substitute, normal summon this Swap Frog, use its effect to send a Treeborn Frog from his deck to the graveyard. He's then going to activate Substitute to summon out a Dupe Frog, and then he's going to use Swap Frog to normal summon a Dupe Frog, and we are Duplocked. We're then going to set 2 cards, normal summon Cyber Valley, and pass the turn. My opponent is going to summon Treeborn Frog in attack position, switch this Dupe Frog, go into the battle phase, and proc our Cyber Valley's effect, letting us draw a card and banishing it, and then they're just going to pass their turn. We draw a Titanial, which is not bad when we have this Trade-In in our hand, and thankfully we draw into a Dandelion. We're going to use the quick draw Dandelion thing. We're going to do this, go into a Drill Warrior, use Drill Warrior's effect to attack directly. We're then going to use Drill Warrior, discarding this card destruction to banish itself, and then we are just going to pass our turn. My opponent normal summons a Substitute. They tribute this Treeborn Frog to summon out a Poison Draw Frog from the deck. They're then going to special summon a Swap Frog from their hand, and on the summon of Swap Frog, I cannot believe this happened in a real duel, but you see, Swap Frog has to send a level 2 or lower water aqua monster from deck or face up field to the graveyard. I can use DNA Transplant, call fire, and there is no... Oh my god. And my opponent cannot send their poison draw frog to the graveyard because this is a fire aqua monster now. I cannot believe DNA Transplant actually did something that affected a game of Yu-Gi-Oh! So he still gets to send a water from his deck to the graveyard, and he sends a water spirit. So my opponent's deck is just completely unhinged. He's then going to use Swap Frog to return itself, and then he just passes the turn. We draw a trade in, we get the Drill Warrior back. We can use Drill Warrior to add back the Titanial. We're then going to use Brain Control to steal my opponent's Dupe Frog, and then we're going to use Mark of the Rose to steal my opponent's other Dupe Frog, and then we're going to tribute both for Titanial. Then we're going to activate Drill Warrior, halving its attack. We can go into the battle phase to attack into the Substitute, dealing 2,700 damage. Then we can attack directly with Drill Warrior, dealing 1,200 damage. And now my opponent is getting very low. We're going to banish the Drill Warrior and then pass the turn. My opponent summons the Treeborn Frog in attack position. They're then going to switch this Poison Draw Frog to attack. Then they're going to activate Pot of Avarice. And my opponent has been very nice to me, so I just let him... pretend that he attacked this token last turn because he's been a nice guy, so I just let him have that token. He then draws two, then he can activate creature swap, but oh no, this Titanial is a fire monster, so we can tribute the Titanial to deal 2,800 damage to my opponent, and the creature swap still resolves, so he will give us this poison draw frog. My opponent goes into the battle phase, crashes the monsters, and then he will just pass his turn. We draw for turn. We're going to use Drill Warrior to add back a Titanial from our graveyard to our hand. Go into the battle phase, and he has Battle Fader, so he is not dead yet. Summon Treeborn Frog, set a monster, and then pass the turn. We can summon the Drill Warrior, add back the Titanial, and we could just half its attack and attack directly, but you know what else we can do is we can just set the Spiritual Fire Art Kuranai, pass the turn, and in the draw phase, tribute our Fire Drill Warrior to effectively win the game. And it is only after the duel that I realized that my opponent's deck is absolutely unhinged. I play cursed decks all the time, but my opponent is playing a ridiculous deck. Look at this. They are playing Kinkabiu, I am not joking, in order to use Descroaking. And just when I thought my opponent's deck could not get any more unhinged, they show me they are playing Dragon. They're playing Dragonice. Just main deck. I love Yu-Gi-Oh. This guy showed up with Descroaking Dragonice Turbo, and honestly, respect to Death Machine. Thank you for the duel, my friend. And I dream of a day that I can make a deck list as cursed as yours.
Okay, I need to stop the duels there because just hear me out. The non-DNA transplant version of this deck is insane. Look at this deck list for the non-DNA transplant version. This is probably the most competitive deck I've ever built. I have been on fire playing this deck. Why do you even need DNA transplant when you can give your opponent the fire monster to steal? You don't need to turn it into a fire. You can just lava golem them, steal the lava golem, and then you've got a fire monster right there. It's crazy how good lava golem is in Edison format. I mean, every deck has some sort of resource game plan. If whether it's recruiters or maybe it's a light monster with Honest in hand or a Blackwing monster with Kaluut in hand. All of these cards that are staples in Edison format, you just drop Lava Golem and you just make them play under your rules. It's like, oh, I don't care what your deck does, your deck is Lava Golem now, and I'm gonna use your monster against you to burn you and attack you, and it's just, it's so much fun. And I cannot say this enough. The fact Nitro Warrior is a fire is insane. It connects the Quick Draw Dandelion side of your deck with the Spiritual Fire Art side of your deck. You can always get Spiritual Fire Art life because you have this engine that you can just use to get a 2,800 fire monster on the field. It's just, it's so good. And the fact that the Fire Art card, you can use it to dodge removal. It's just, oh my god, I need to take this version of the deck to a tournament and just try it. Because, I mean, I've been playing a lot of games with the DNA Transplant version, but I just realized how little DNA Transplant does when you are giving your opponent Lava Golem and then stealing it. But you guys don't want to see me play a competitive burn deck, even though it's a sick, sick deck. Let's get back to the cursed tech. DNA Transplant is a funny card. It is kind of bad. The shell it's in, it makes it so it's so useless because you could already accomplish the feat of spiritual fire art with a lava golem. So it's like, what are you even doing there? You're just a funny meme at that point. You know, I'm gonna have to put DNA transplant in the small possibility of doing anything because the deck essentially functions without it. Although it's very funny when it resolves and your opponent will freak out. I mean, if that's what you want, then play this deck for sure. But if you want to actually win some duels with an extremely aggressive fire burn deck that steals your opponent's monsters that you gave them, this is the list you're going to want to use. Now that that's out of the way, I just want to mention that this deck would be the perfect Berserk Dragon deck ever. Just imagine this scenario. You tribute summon two recruiters to summon Lava Golem on your opponent's side of the field. You activate Mark of the Rose to steal that Lava Golem. You attack with that Lava Golem for 3,000 damage. Then you flip Spiritual Fire Art, Kerr and I, tribute that Lava Golem, inflict 3,000 more damage. Then, still in the battle phase, a level 8 monster has been sent to your graveyard this turn so you can activate the quick play and deal with Dark Ruler, summon out 3,500 attack, Berserk Dragon from the deck, and attack for game. I mean, but you know, I said I was going to take a break from my two past lover dragons, and I don't need to put Berserk Dragon and Montage Dragon in every deck. This episode does not need it. And this is the end of the episode. I'm not going to mention Berserk Dragon again, no matter how incredibly cool and funny it would be to pull off that combo. And so that is going to wrap up this episode of Cursed Tech. A little bit of a different one. The jank deck turned into a competitive deck, but what can you say? You don't know what to expect on Cursed Tech. And don't forget to listen to my heavy metal album. Links in the description. You know what? This is the perfect plug. I'm gonna use King of the Skull Servants, the song, as the outro music of this video.